Hello everybody, Mindstorm here. Welcome back to Hearts of Iron for the United States. In the last episode, we continued working on building up, as is usual at the beginning of a Hearts of Iron 4 game. So, we got technology unlocked, we're working on our armor, we got heavy tanks unlocked, we're working on light self-propelled artillery. Currently researching light tank destroyers. I also basically started upgrading our old battleships to use newer engines and guns. You know, there was a comment that that isn't necessarily the best thing to do, but you know what? It's part of me kind of learning how that system works. So I'm going to keep running through it. So we'll get all of these New York and Pennsylvania's refit with better guns and engines. We'll probably have to refit them again at some point for better AA and radar, but we'll get around to that at some point. And working on building up the shipyard so we can get that done a bit quicker. Still need to get through some more military factories. Let me just actually alternate these a little bit. No, that's not what I want to do. Yes. That is what I want to do. There we go. Right, so we're working on both new military factories and new shipyards on a regular basis. All right. To keep an eye on that. Alright, back up to 133 naval experience. How are our ships? No, these guys are exercising. How are our ships? We're fine. Let's keep things moving here a little bit. We are currently working on democratic socialism. So, in a little bit, we will be switching to communism, and we'll see how that goes. Currently training armored divisions. I think it might be a good idea to train up some more infantry divisions. I did just edit them. Support anti-air. I could throw that in. Thing is, we don't have any anti-aircraft guns being manufactured as of yet. So that's another thing we're going to have to get going. What do I have a surplus of? We have a sizable surplus of infantry equipment. Okay, so here's what we're going to do. We're going to back the infantry equipment off. I'm just going to back these guys off, back those guys off. Alright. Make sure that there's at least one factory doing everything. And then we'll go ahead and say we need all that. Alright. We need some chromium, apparently. We'll get that, some more of that from Turkey. And the other thing I think is going to be a good idea is to train some more of those infantry divisions. T-56 gun motor carriage is done. I want to get heavy tank destroyers as well. We will be putting these in at some point, but they're not a high priority at the moment, but I want to have them in the mix. because I like to put heavy tank destroyers into my infantry divisions. These guys are going to get edited. They're going to be taking light self-propelled artillery and light tank destroyers in addition to support. But we're going to need a lot more army experience. Are there any wars going on? The Japanese-Chinese war is going on. Can I send an attaché? Need 100 political power. Yeah. Alright, well, let's at least start training these guys. We're gonna do 3 sets of 8 for a whole new army. Just dump them somewhere in the middle of the country. Senator speaks out against government policy. Leave that as is. We're short artillery and we're short anti-air. Anti-air is going to take a long time. Improved infantry equipment. Yeah, that's good. Alright, what is Germany doing? We don't know. Because we don't have enough. Alright, House Committee supports presidential policy. We have a lot of House support. Alright, democratic socialism is done. Alright, liberty for the Philippines. Requires full desegregation. I'm not sure we're going to be heading in that direction just yet. US-USSR economic cooperation. I don't know what that does. End monarchism. I don't think we're going to be trying to antagonize the British just yet. Rubber Reserve Company. Intervention in Asia. Daily command power gain multiplier plus 10%. National Spirit Intervention in the Americas, planning speed plus 5%. Alright, we're not going to be doing that just yet. Okay, we got a bunch of stuff over here we can do. Tank experiments. Mobilization speed, airborne division, first special service. Additional army experience. Let's go for... First Special Service Force. Let's go for that. Looks like we still have Congress involved. Second Vienna Award. The treaty's been signed at Vienna following the German arbitration that will see Northern Transylvania restored to Hungarian rule. The territory had previously been awarded to the Kingdom of Romania upon the conclusion of World War I, leading to a bitter dispute. Are these the first of many borders to be adjusted now that a new order seems to have been established in Europe? We'll see. Okay, yep, now Hungary gets its little little tail there in Romania. Formation fighting is done. We'll keep working on these. Start hunt and destroy. We get our heavy tank destroyers. We'll have those as an option at some point. It is 1939. We can start working on the M3 Lees. Do we want to? Let's get construction 3. There's an armored division. It's done. Well, things are coming along. Bulgaria declared war on the Kingdom of Romania. Really? So there is going to be an election. Next election is in November of 1940. We'll have to see what happens when that occurs. So we're making another one of these. Actually, what I probably should have done was two ocean navy, but we need those senators. So what can we do about those senators? So we have to keep burning political power, getting those guys on our side. What is reducing our political power gain? Slow recovery. I need 58 senators. This will reduce our political power gain for 30 days and... Alright, do the lobbying effort. If that's a mechanic we're going to have to, you know, deal with, then we're going to have to deal with it. Alright, how are we doing here? You guys are all good. You guys are all good, so go ahead and stop. And you guys... You guys are all good, so go ahead and stop. So we can stop using up equipment. Alright, let's just keep things at high speed. Let's see how things are going in Bulgaria. Things are not going well for Bulgaria. Looks like they bit off a little bit more than they can chew. Well, I could send volunteers. Do I want to send volunteers? I can send 4 divisions. I really could use some army experience. Let's send our armor. Should I send my armor? Probably not a good idea. You guys are really short equipment. Yeah, you're still not getting any tanks. That's weird. Alright, we're gonna send regular infantry. We're gonna send some regular infantry. I don't know how long this is gonna last. We're gonna split you off as another army. We're gonna give you a commander. We're gonna give you Mark Clark? Yes, Mark Clark. We're gonna give you a unique color. We're gonna make you orange. Alright. Actually, that's not a unique color. We're gonna make you blue. There you go. And we're gonna send you as volunteers into Romania. Because Romania looks to win, we're gonna get involved in there and hopefully get some army experience in some combat. Day will arrive on April 7th. Hopefully that war doesn't end by then. I should have been a little bit more proactive about checking that. Oh well. But, because now we're communist, we can send volunteers all over the place. We could also send volunteers to China to fight the Japanese. We can send 3 divisions. Let's do that. Let's go ahead and do that. You guys, let's grab 3 divisions. Let's get you, Hodges, and make you red. And we're gonna send you guys as volunteers. First special service force done. Up to 54 in support. Department of Defense, maximum command power increase plus 25. Tank experiments. Current support. Yeah, we can't go that route. Can't go that route. I would say we need to do the USSR economic cooperation. Let's go ahead and do it. Alright, our 4 divisions in Romania have arrived. Ready to move. Let's get them on a front with a battle plan. Move out. Get out there a little bit quicker because we are running out of time to participate. They just took Sophia. Okay, yeah. Did not quite get in there fast enough. Ready to move.
Ready to move.
Ready to move.
Integrated support.
Orders.
Get regimented combat teams. There we go. We still have guys heading to Oh, they changed hands. Okay. Okay, so then actually we need you guys to be in a different army. How come I can't assign them to anything when I have them selected? Alright, you guys returned. Okay, alright, now that's working. These are National Guards divisions. That means you go back to there. One of you, head back to that guy. The rest of you go as volunteers to China. Come on, volunteers. Oh, actually, we can send four. Okay. There. Send volunteers. Go. I don't have any delusions that I would be able to throw back the Japanese. We gotta take a look at our... Let's get the M1 Thompsons. Alright, there we go. You're going to become a new army. We're going to use Hodges there. And you guys are going to be yellow in color. There we go. We're going to send you to the Mexico border, and you guys are going to go to that army directly. All right. My volunteers have arrived. Where do we want to get them involved? Let's get them over here. Alright, so battle plan is set. Planning bonus is building. Alright, floating fortress is done. Let's get carrier battle groups. Research. Execute the plan. Come on, let's drive them back. There we go. Why didn't we hold that? Now you guys are called China again. Okay. But my volunteers are still there, so that's fine. That's perfectly fine. Alright, France pursues nuclear technology. Following initial tests, the politicians of France decided to direct French research toward the development of nuclear technology. The technology is still highly experimental, and there is great uncertainty whether it has any practical applications at all. Who knows where this might lead their war effort? They're not at war with anybody yet. Alright. Two Ocean Navy Act. There we go. That's what I wanted. German Reich forms anti-Soviet pact. The German Reich has long condemned communism in all forms and has made diplomatic motions to demand other nations oppose it as well. Now the German Reich has offered states under immediate threat from communism a chance to form a pact against the Soviet Union. Any country in the pact will be committed to fighting a war against the Soviet Union should there come a time when a member is attacked. The struggle will only hasten the workers' revolution. Okay, so. That's going to get us 10 naval dockyards. Speaking of naval dockyards, we need some more military factories. Let's go ahead and swap that around a little bit. There we go. Alright, well now that we have some experience, let's go ahead and make some edits to our armored divisions. Let's get them some recon. And let's get them, actually, let's get them some light self-propelled artillery. That will also be helpful. Alright, get in there. Get in there and help. Mexico is justifying a war goal against us. Well, I have a big ol' army right on your border. Is that really something you want to do? Let's begin getting battle plans established, just in case we end up at war with Mexico. I want these guys to push for the Mexico City, and our armor do a spearhead assault for Mexico City. There we go. Volunteer forces and transfer. Oh my goodness, this is... That's getting rather annoying. Maybe I should just send my volunteers to Japan, if the Chinese can't sort themselves out. Senator for Wyoming offers support. They make a lot of good points. Good. Oh yeah, and you guys are also going to need orders. Construction 3 is done. We can get concentrated industry 3. I think I'll just let my volunteers come home and stay home. March southwards. What's this? Annex war goal against Guatemala, Honduras, and El Salvador. I think that we are already guaranteeing their independence. So that's what's going on. Okay. So they launch a war against Guatemala, we will be at war with Mexico, and then we will be at war with the rest of the Axis. Alright, so get our guys back to the front. Well, at least they got a little bit of combat experience. Mexico has declared war on Honduras. We are guaranteeing the independence of Honduras. And why are we not in this fight? Mexico declared war on Guatemala. And why are we not in this war? We are guaranteeing their independence. Do I have to have, like, some sort of official declaration of war? I don't know. That's odd. I don't see anything in here. More than 50% war support. Has completed a limited focus, limited intervention. Is that what I need to do? Well, I can't. Intervention in the Americas. I guess once we finish that, we're gonna head for this. Mexico's starting to get aggressive. I can't justify a war goal. I can send volunteers. That's the only thing that I can do right now. I can send one division. All right. Well, I have to sort that out because we are at the end of the episode here. So, we'll see what happens with all of this when we come back. So, hope you guys enjoyed it. Thanks for watching. Go ahead, like, subscribe, and comment, and I will see you next time.